Welcome back to the Reflactor channel. I recently acquired this used Maksutov-Cassegrain telescope, but it didn't come with any mount. That left me with a few options. The first was that I could tape it to my Dobsonian telescope. Secondly, I could mount it to the top of my heavy-duty Orion tripod. The problem with this is that this telescope weighs 12 pounds, and the center of gravity is so far above the tripod's pivot point that as soon as I put this on, it would tend to either fall forward or fall backwards. So I thought, wouldn't it be great if I could mount this at the telescope's own center of gravity? So I started researching and I found a few options. However, for a telescope this large and this heavy, I found that the Twilight I from Explorer Scientific was the only one that checked all the right boxes. I found a gentleman in Kentucky named Rico who had one used for sale. And here it is! You know, I've had a chance to use this for a couple of months now, and I'm a little bit smitten with this mount. Let me demonstrate how this works. The attachment plate on the Twilight uses the Vixen standard dovetail. Here's the part that goes on the bottom of the telescope. You put this right here in the slot, and then it has two screws. This big one is for the main clutching power, and then it has this little one that works as a safety backup. I like that idea. It has the two slow motion control cables. It has this one for azimuth, and here's a lock and unlock, so if it's unlocked, you can move it by hand, and you lock this, and then the slow motion control turns it in the azimuth direction. Now, similarly, here on the altitude or elevation axis, it has a lock here, so I can move it by hand if it's unlocked, but as soon as I tighten this, then the slow motion cable works just fine. This tripod is rock solid. It has a leg spreader that you can lock rigid with the knurled nut. It has rubber feet, but you can remove those to reveal hard points if that works better for the surface that you're observing from.
Oh boy.
If you'd like to tinker, then you're in luck because this mount can be disassembled and reconfigured in almost any imaginable way to meet your needs. And in a little bit, I'm going to show you how I reconfigured this to make it as easy as possible for me to use. First, one of the coolest features is that all the Allen screws that you see here use the same Allen head wrench, and it's held to the mount itself with a permanent magnet.
How cool is that?
Now, for some reason, you want to take this vertical part and tilt it back so that your telescope can get a steeper angle. You're in luck because this part comes off and can be tilted back and reattached with these screws. Now, at first glance, you would think with all these combinations here, you'd have a bunch of combinations, 45 degrees, etc. But they only drilled the base here and here. Let me show you what I mean. Let's pull this off. As you can see, the threaded screw holes are only right there. So that means that you could attach it here, which is at 30 degrees, and you can attach it here.
Perfectly vertical.
Or you can continue on going, and you can get here at another 30 degrees. If I were to modify this, what I would do is actually drill a hole there and drill a hole there and thread it. And that would give you a couple of more options, right? This would give you 60 degrees, and it would also allow you to go completely horizontal if you wanted to. But let's put it back to vertical, because that works for my telescope. It can also be adjusted in the azimuth direction with respect to where the slow motion cable attaches to the mounting plate right here. For example, when I'm actively using the telescope, this is a little bit awkward because the angle is too far this way. It sure would be great if I could move this out that way. Well, that's an easy thing to do. Let me show you. There's a lot of options here. Look at that. I have no idea what these inner threaded screws are for, though. If you know, please leave a comment down in the comment section. Let's reattach. Much more comfortable. You can make similar changes to the altitude head. Look at all the options you have here. E each axis has two potential inputs for control. That allows you to put the slow motion control cable either on this side, or you can put it on this side. So it doesn't matter if you're left-handed or right-handed. It's your choice. The slow motion cables are pretty smooth, but you can adjust the tension on this mount. And it's one of the more clever engineering design choices for this. With the right tools, you can do this pretty easy. I'm going to show you on the azimuth because it's a little bit easier to get to, but you can do just the same thing on the elevation axis as well. Here's the drive gear that turns the azimuth axis. Now I'll remove this. There are two brass nubs, one on each end, and there's a little metal collar. If you look closely at these metal collars, they're not concentric, it's off center. It has two little dimples on each side of that. There's a set screw on top. We'll have to loosen that just a little bit, like that. So I have a special tool here that I actually got from an estate sale, but you can buy these from Harbor Freight. And you put this in the two little holes, and you can adjust this closer. This, what I've just done is moved the drive gear closer to this little tooth gear on the axis, which makes this super tight. Or you can move it farther away, which makes it super loosey-goosey. You don't want that. I'm going to put it back to where it was, which is right about there. And then tighten that set screw. Don't forget that. And then it goes right back to the tension that you want. And you can do this on each side. It's pretty cool. You can also do this on the elevation axis up here.
If you're enjoying this video, please push that like button. It means the world to little channels like this. By the way, an easy way to support this channel is to use the affiliate links down in the description box. Anyhow, go ahead and boop that like button. Now, the gentleman that I bought this mount from packed it very, very well, but despite his best efforts, the shipping company kicked it halfway to Texas. Now, it arrived okay, except this axis lock up here was busted. I contacted Explore Scientific, and to my shock, a human responded. After a couple of back and forths to figure out exactly the part that was damaged, they offered to sell me a replacement for just $20, which included shipping. Now, if you've ever tried to order replacement parts from another famous large telescope company and you're not the original owner, well, you can understand my total shock at how wonderful the Explore Scientific support team was. So when you're deciding which mount to buy, please take into consideration their level of support. By using this universal Vixen dovetail, this Twilight I mount allows you to attach any telescope to the mount, as long as you can attach this block to the telescope itself. I've been using this for a couple of months now, and I have to say, I really like it, and I think you might too. Of course, we are not operating in a vacuum here. There are other altaz mounts out there, and in fact, if you have an altaz mount that you really like, please tell me about it in the comments section down below. Now that you have a solid mount to attach your telescope to, you may be interested in taking some really cool astrophotos with your smartphone. If you want to do it the easy way, check out this quick tutorial up here. Now, if you'd like to see the hardest telescope restoration project I've ever done, check out this video down here. Until next time, clear skies, everybody.